Good Sunday morning and welcome. I am your servant, Elder Jennifer Ashburn, and this day, as every day the Lord sends, I am standing on the promises of the Lord here at the place of Providence where the Reverend Joseph Strong is our proud pastor. And right now I invite you to ask the Lord to open your heart, to make ready your mind, to speak to your spirit and your situation, and then to move in your life as the Lord sees fit. Shall we pray? Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you this beautiful Sunday morning in the humblest manner that we know how, Lord, just to say thank you. Because, Lord, you've been just that good, and you have been just that kind, that if we had 10,000 tongues, Lord, we couldn't thank you enough for your traveling mercies, for your love, for your guidance, for your healing power. Lord, you healed us. You tapped us with your finger of love and you said, get up and be about my Father's work. Lord, we thank you for that honor. We thank you for that privilege. And Father, as we come before your children this morning, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And all the children of God said, amen. Amen. Now, our Sunday school lesson for today is taken from Exodus, the 18th chapter and the 20th verse. Teach them his decrees and instructions, and show them the way that they are to live and how they are to behave. Our 3 points of power for our Sunday school lesson today are hinder, help, and holy, and our spiritual foundation focuses our praise and worship. First of all, hinder. As God's people were marching through the desert, day after day, they didn't always act like a godly people. Their behavior was a hindrance to them, to their achievements. They didn't get along with each other, and that's a hindrance. We can only imagine the hindrances, the problems that 2.4 million people had as they camped closely together in the desert. Moses found himself sitting from sunrise to sunset, listening to people telling him about their problems. Those things that hindered them from living the life that the Lord would have them to live. Moses had to decide who was right and who was wrong. He listened to their big problems and to their little problems. I want you to imagine Moses sitting in his tent door. Now, maybe there is a line of 1,000 people waiting to tell him that he stole my camel and she put her tent too close to mine and she borrowed my cooking pot and never returned it, and on and on and on. Poor Moses. He sat there day after day listening to all these complaints that hindered the Lord's people from being the people that he called them to be. Instead of praising God for their deliverance, they complained. That's a hindrance. Anything that keeps us from praising and worshiping God hinders us from receiving all that the Lord would have us to have. The line of people waiting day after day probably stretched out for as far as the eye could see. What an exhausting, frustrating situation that must have been for Moses as well as the people. If those people in line were anything like the people today, and they were, they probably thought that their problem was the most important and resented having to wait in line for a long time in order to see Moses. The people with serious problems probably fumed when they heard the people in front of them taking up Moses' time with petty hindrances like her little girl pulled my little girl's hair and I want you to do something to stop it. Let's look at the hindrances of the children of Israel that they probably brought to Moses to solve. Let's list them. We We've got famous lines from those who complain. He stole my camel, and she took my pot, and his brother hit my brother, Moses. You must make him stop. We don't have enough water, and they won't move their tent. And I'm sicking of walking in the desert. Moses, are we there yet? And I'm sick of eating this manna. And is the quail all gone? I'm hungry. She stole my husband. Moses, can I borrow some money? Poor Moses. He allowed himself to be swallowed up with all the things that were needed to be done. And without realizing it, and probably without the people realizing it, they were all getting very weary. Now, I don't know about you, but there are times when I am weary of well-doing. And when I get to times like that, I have learned to ask the Lord to take my hand and to lead me on and let me stand. Please join us as we listen to James Cleveland singing, precious Lord, please take my hand.
Precious Lord, take my hand. Let me stand. Come in, dear Lord.
Strength. metaphors, and please use your study guide that you can pick up at the church office to complete your metaphor poem. Now, when Moses' father-in-law, Jethro, came to visit him, he saw all the problems that the people were having with each other. And he saw something else. He saw Moses sitting from sunrise to sunset without help, listening to the people as they told him about their troubles. Moses had to decide what was right and what was wrong. "Why are you doing this to yourself?" Moses' father-in-law asked. "You sit here all day while all of these people stand around you with their problems. You're not doing a good thing for these people, and you're not really doing a good thing for yourself. This is too much work for just one man, Moses. You need help." And we all need help from time to time. Has there ever been a time when you took on more than you could do without help? I know I have. So what do I do, preacher? What do I do when I have bit off more than I can chew? What do I do when I really don't have the knowledge or ability or the strength to do what God has called me to do? One thing that I have learned is that God will not give you a vision without provision. If you humble yourself and you pray, God will provide the help that you need, and he will reveal to you in his time how to accomplish the visions that he has given you. I know he will provide help for you because he's provided help for me. I know he'll provide help for me because he did it for Moses. And I know he will provide help for you because our God is no respecter of persons. And what he does for one, he'll do for two. God provided for Moses in the form of his father-in-law to help him. However, Jethro didn't push Moses to take his advice. He told Moses to go to God and talk about the suggestions. He told Moses to go to God in prayer. He told Moses to look to the hills from whence cometh his help. His help and his strength will come from the Lord who made heaven and earth. And I don't know about you, but when I find myself facing problems that I can't solve, when I find that I am wading in the troubled water, I know that it is God. It is the Lord who troubles the water, and it is the Lord who will save me. Join me with sweet honey in the rock as we sing, "Wade in the water, wade in the water. God is going to trouble the water.
Wade in the water, wade in the water, children. Wade in the water,
when my God's gonna trouble the water.
Come on and wade in the water. You gotta wade. Dressed up in white,
God's gonna trouble the world.
You know they must be the children of the Israelites.
God's gonna trouble the world.
Well, now you wanna wait.
Poetry with me and singing with me as we integrate the arts and the word while we are standing on the promises here at the place. Diocese of Providence, where Reverend Joseph Strong is our proud pastor. Our Sunday school promise for today was taken from Exodus, the 18th chapter and the 20th verse. Teach them his decrees and instructions, and show them the way that they are to live and how they are to behave. Our 3 points of power for today have been hinder, help, and holy. And our spiritual foundations are to study our praise and worship. Finally, holy. Moses' father-in-law suggested that Moses look for men who loved God, men who were holy, which is our third point of power. Moses look for men who are honest, men who are holy, men who are trustworthy, men who are holy, men who hated taking bribes, men who are holy. Jethro said that Moses should make these holy men judges. Some of the holy men were to be over 10 people. Some of the holy men were to be over 50 people. Some of the holy men were to be over 100 people. Some of these holy men were to be over 1,000 people. Every 10 people had a holy judge for their problems. And if that judge couldn't solve it, he took it to the judge over 50. If those holy men couldn't solve it, they took it to the judge over 100. If the judge over 100 couldn't solve it, couldn't find the right answer, he took it to the judge over 1,000. If that judge did not know the right answer, he took it to Moses. These judges could decide the easy cases and then take only the difficult cases to Moses. Our holy God provided for the people, and our holy God provided holy help for Moses. Do you suppose that the holy leaders of our church get tired? Do you imagine that Pastor Strong gets tired sometimes? We as a people of a holy God need to pray and ask God how we can help our pastor. We need to look for ways that we can help our leaders in our lives, at home and at church and in school. Look at these pictures here. What are some things that these people are doing to help in our community, to help those that are least, to help those? I challenge you to find some way to help a holy leader this week, to help someone, knowing that as you help others, you are helping our holy God. Please join me with Donnie McClurkin as we worship our holy God. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty.
I will lift my voice and I will sing. I will sing
holy.
My Lord and Savior, my God and King, I will sing
holy.
I will sing
holy. I will praise the Lamb of God who sits upon the throne. I will worship Him and give the praise to Him alone. He who was and is to come, I will sing before His throne forever.
Yeah.
Forever.
Thank you so much for staying with me and praying with me, writing poetry with me, singing with me, illustrating the pictures with me as we integrate the arts in the Word here at the Place of Providence, where Reverend Joseph Strong is our proud pastor. Our Sunday school lesson promise for today was taken from Exodus, the 18th chapter and the 20th verse. Teach them his decrees and instructions, and show them the way they are to live and how they are to behave. Our three points of power have been hinder, help, and holy, and our spiritual foundations that we studied for today are praise and worship. Now look at our golden text that was taken from Exodus, the 18th chapter and the 20th verse. Teach them his decrees and instructions, and show them the way that they are to live and how they are to behave. When Moses was spending every waking moment listening to the people's problems, he didn't have time to teach them what the Lord wanted them to do. If the people knew how God wanted them to act and to behave according to his commandments, they may not have had so many difficulties with one another. Once Moses followed his father-in-law's suggestions, once Moses went to God in prayer to see if he was really supposed to do that, he chose other holy men to help him judge the people. Then he only had to listen to the most difficult cases, and he had more time to teach the people God's ways. Right now, I encourage you to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and then to find a Bible-based church where you can find out God's instructions for your life. I invite you to come here to the Place of Providence and to give your hand to our proud pastor, Reverend Joseph Strong, but then give your heart to God and join us as we study the Lord's Word so that we may move in the way that the Lord would have us to go. To Pastor Strong, to the Deacon Board, to the Mother Board, and to all of God's children here at the Place of Providence. Until next week, continue to stand.